I have come to know Saint Daniel Comboni as one who came from rather a poor family, but who then developed the passion for Africa. He says also in his writings that the first love of his heart was Africa, and was ready to dedicate his whole life for Africa. Coming from a poor family, he goes to the Institute of Mazza in Verona, where he has an opportunity to prepare himself for being a priest. And it was there that he got to know about other missionaries who were in the mission in Africa and in other countries. But after having discerned his vocation, after having realized that his vocation really was for Africa, he got independent. He wanted to be different, and he founds his own institute of fathers, who are now the Comboni missionaries and the Comboni sisters. And he goes out to Africa with the conviction that Africa was missing what would improve, what would guarantee the dignity of the people of Africa by not knowing Christ. They were the poorest because they never knew Christ. He goes to them to bring them the light of the gospel. He never went as an explorer, as an adventurer, but he went as an evangelizer. He believed in the regeneration of Africa, which according to me was a generation giving birth to life possibilities for the peoples of Africa, and becoming the first bishop in Sub-Sahara Africa, it was a sign that the church was now convinced that Africa is a part of the people of God and had the right also to belong to the universal church. And his canonization recognition being a saint is, according to me, a sign that the church now believes this man, so outstanding in his missionary zeal, was ready to offer his life, to consecrate his life for Africa. I love calling him a prophet because he spoke the uncomfortable word at that time, that Africa had the right and no one and nothing could close Africa out of the generative power of the gospel.